Between the Miami-inspired setting, the story heavily influenced by Scarface and Miami Vice, the tropical 80s vibe, this Hawaiian shirt, and Ray Liotta voicing the protagonist, what's the next thing about Vice City that people tend to love the most? The radio soundtrack. Given that Grand Theft Auto Vice City takes place in 1986, all of the music is obviously going to be period-specific, meaning that every radio station in the game is, for the most part, going to feature popular hits from the early to mid-1980s. Vice City really introduced me to the greatness that is 80s music. These songs give me nostalgia for the 2000s like it gives someone born 15 years before me nostalgia for hearing them in the 80s for the first time. When the game was first released in 2002, Rockstar also released a box set compilation of the entire soundtrack, something I unfortunately don't own, but I do have a Wave 103 CD, and let me tell you, it is great for having in the car. All the CDs are, I'm sure. Looking at the track lists of the CDs, it's going to contain the fairly obvious stuff. Almost every song that was featured on each station in the game is on the CD, with the exception of a few. I'm gonna guess that this has to do with copyright reasons or licensing issues. Just like how they have to get permission and pay a licensing fee to feature these songs in the game, they also have to do the same in order to put these songs in the CD. Now, because of this, I'm gonna assume that that's why Obsession by Animotion is unfortunately absent from this CD. Which is too bad, since that's a great song to listen to when you're driving around the city at night in real life, too. On the Flash FM CD, according to the track listings, Japanese Boy by Anika, One Thing Leads to Another by The Fix, Steppin' Out by Joe Jackson, and Video Killed the Radio Star by The Buggles are also gone from the compilation of that radio station. But when you take a look at the Flash FM CD's track list for the European release, you'll notice that there aren't just a few songs that are missing, there's extra songs that weren't even in the game. I Wanna Be a Cowboy by Boys Don't Cry, Smuggler's Blues by Glenn Frey, and Hold the Line by Toto. While I don't have access to the actual CD, the tracklist can still be seen online through Discogs and Amazon UK. Obviously, we can't say anything for certain, but I would not be surprised if these were songs that they wanted to include in the game that they ended up cutting, possibly last minute, which would indicate why they're left over on this CD. Due to copyright reasons, I unfortunately can't play these songs in the video because it's still licensed music, but links to them are included in the description. And if you've played GTA San Andreas, which I'm sure you have, you'll already know what Hold the Line sounds like since that song was included in that game's soundtrack, on the classic rock station KDST. It's pretty interesting how a song that was cut from one game eventually ended up in another. I feel like the song suits San Andreas more than Vice City anyway, but maybe that's just because I'm already used to hearing the song while playing San Andreas. I Wanna Be a Cowboy would have been an interesting addition. I guess you could say it was the Old Town Road of the 80s, or maybe Red Dead Redemption, the synth-pop musical. And finally, there's Smuggler's Blues by the late Glenn Frey. In my opinion, this song not being included was a big miss for Vice City's soundtrack. This song is literally about a majority of the subject matter of the game. Plus, the song inspired a great episode of Miami Vice, and Glenn Frey even had a role in the episode, playing Jimmy Cole, a pilot who smuggles drugs into Florida and plays guitar in his hangar when he isn't flying. Great episode overall, and if you've never seen Miami Vice before, I'd highly suggest watching it, because you'll clearly see the amount of influence that the series had on GTA Vice City, and it's almost certainly where they got the idea to feature Smuggler's Blues. Because the radio stations that make up Vice City's soundtrack are each one long MP3 file per station, with no randomization between songs, DJ dialogue, and commercials like how San Andreas, GTA 4, and GTA 5 had, we can't easily figure out what songs might have been cut from the game. GTA 4 and GTA 5 featured a ton of leftover songs in the American.gxt file. We're definitely lucky that these extra songs ended up being left over on the Flash FM CD in Europe, since it gives us at least some indication of extra songs that they might have wanted to include. Of course, the Flash FM CD in Europe is the only CD in the soundtrack to include extra songs. We still don't know what songs might have once been intended for other stations that were later cut, or if any of these cut songs ended up appearing in future games, similar to how Hold the Line later appeared in San Andreas. But we do know of an artist who likely had a song cut from Vice City that later had songs in a future game, and a bigger role, too. Remember in my first video about the Gator Keys how I cited the hidden dialogue discovered by Robert Alan Rusk? Well, besides the Gator Keys being mentioned, there's also a reference to Kenny Loggins. According to Rusk, these extra lines of dialogue between Tommy and Lance were meant to be included in one of the missions for Diaz. One line has one of the duo asking, "You cool with Kenny Loggins?" followed by the other responding with, "Hell, I love this record." I guess that makes it pretty clear that they wanted to include a song by Kenny Loggins in the game, and Tommy and Lance would have been listening to it together at some point. Of course, what we don't know is which song would have been included. Given what most of Kenny Loggins' songs are like, it most likely would have been on Flash FM. Also, it's pretty funny how they go from having to cut a Kenny Loggins song in Vice City to actually casting Kenny Loggins himself to be a DJ for Los Santos Rock Radio in GTA 5, with two of his songs included in the game. Maybe one of these Loggins songs from 5 was originally meant to be in Vice City. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. Hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.